This sign is a long way to Temporary, and we know it's clean. This is my team, pack up your troubles.
Sure. Do we have a...
What's that?
Oh!
So
medley. I'd just like to thank you all for being such a super audience. I've enjoyed tonight, I hope you all. I hope the company has as well. Just one or two things to remember. Remember this weekend, the clocks go forward an hour, and we lose another hour in bed. So we'll just say, why don't they keep on putting them back, because we have that extra hour every year. The other thing is that I'd like to call on Mr. Tom Evans to come and say a couple of words, please. Thank you, Tom.
My duty to propose a vote of thanks for this evening's entertainment. Something did strike me about it when Ben Penny was singing Walter, Walter, lead me to Walter. I thought to myself, well, if my second name was Walter instead of George, we could have had that. Of a Derek Painter joke. Which one? I don't think he's told this one. But I was told a story the other day about two senior citizens from Llangadden who decided to get married. The bridegroom was John and the bride was Mary. So they went into Lambercrigan on the Saturday morning and they got married. On Saturday afternoon, Mary was seen in the local spa shop by her friend. And her friend said to her, Mary, what are you doing here? I thought you'd have been on your honeymoon. To which Mary replied, well, John's gone on his honeymoon to Aberystwyth. I didn't go because I'd been there before. I reckon if I ever get to make a sermon, I'll have to rehearse in the office for a month. But I must thank a few people. I must thank Winifred Apple there on the piano. I'm Junior Winifred Apple. I don't know whether you know it, but this used to be produced by the Reverend Derek Bedford. And one of the last things he said before he left was, you must carry on the music hall. And John Hughes had just retired from the bank after I don't know how many years hard slog. So he took on the production duties of the music hall. So with his genius for figures, and after his experience this year, I reckon that next year the Methodist singers will be making a takeover bid for Andrew Lloyd Webber's. Somebody who's always forgotten, I'd like to thank Anne Smith, who's up the back there behind making sandwiches for the moment, for arranging all the props. And the ladies for the catering, and Derek for all his jokes. And I think I must thank the gentlemen ushers because they've really done all the work. I'll tell you something, I bought this suit 30 years ago from Bradley's for 28 quid. Comes out once a year now. At least Mona's appreciated it. But most of all, I'd like to thank you for coming to support us. Because in having this do tonight, we have proved that you can be happy in church. You don't have to be circumcised. And that's what going to church is all about, learning how to be happy and bringing happiness to other people. And I think that's the best thing. like everybody here to be quiet while everybody here claps you for coming. Please join in every one of the next songs, and if you want to clap, clap. If you want to stamp, you can stamp.
Be wrong of me first not to thank Tom for those very kind remarks. I can assure you if I bought a suit in Burton's 30 years ago. I don't know how I'm going to live with this lot behind me because we're on BBC Wales here. We're all being taken on video, so I don't know, they'll be really big-headed, well, until they see it, probably. But I'd like to thank Harold Woosnam here, who has been busy on the video camera. Harold and I played football. I played for Chirk. I used to play football. I played for Chirk, and he used to play for St. Martin's. And we had a right ding-dong on many occasions, and then when I went down the grade a bit, I played for Oswald Street Celtic. I still play against Harold, and he always brushed my feet from under me, you know. But we are thankful to Harold for taking the video. I would feel happier if I was on Celebrity Golf tonight with his son, Ian, as you know, we all know about Mr. and Mrs. Woodman's son, Ian, and he's a great credit to Wales. You can say Wales. Yeah. He took me on the golf course and saw my swing. Perhaps I wouldn't want to play golf. Anyway, we had thought of doing this concert for charity this year because you supported us so well, but suddenly we found that we had some very big expenses in the chapel, so it had to be charity belongs at home, so that the profit from this concert goes towards these essential repairs, and I'm told that if we're not careful the back wall would be collapsing. So we had to have it done. So anyway, I would like to thank the choir. We've only been rehearsing this concert since mid-January, and I know you'll say that. I thought you had. But if I had this lot for 12 months, I couldn't be. So, and of course, as Thomas said, Mary, well, we couldn't do without Mary, could we? No. She's the chief administrator, treasurer, organizer, and everything, and we're pleased to leave that in her capable hands. For a few weeks, we did have the help of Vio to do a bit of choreography, because I didn't want to know about choreography. I still don't want to know about it. I've seen these moves tonight, I still don't want to know about choreography. But yes, you can appreciate this.
Thank you.
served in the interval, so if you'll keep your seat, the refreshments will be brought to you. The other thing is that the show tonight is going to be a series of medleys and solos. You're welcome to join in. In fact, you're encouraged to join in on the medleys. Please to help drum the singing if you can. And warm applause will be appreciated in between the medleys. So, without further ado, we'll go down memory lane and here we go again.
Here we are again.
Here we are again.
It's about the beer.
people got pets in here? Can you put your hands up if you've got pets?
Come on, I can put your hands up, thank you very much. I haven't exactly got pets at all, but we got bats in the attic. Big colony of bats in the attic, can't get rid of them, of course. Have you noticed? Animals have got their own little character, haven't they? You're just like a human being. And I was watching this colony of bats last week, and a new small bat arrived in the colony, a young bat. And just like little lads around here, they're very, very cocky. They know it all, they can't be taught. And there he was on the first night, went to the door of the colony and said, "Well, I'm all out now, go get me meal. Get a bit of blood, get a bit of meat, I'm going to enjoy this." So, old bat by the side looked up and said, "Waste of time, don't go out tonight, you won't get anything." But youngsters, of course, they know it all. Out he went. We left for about 4 hours, came back, nothing. Old bat, told you. This happened the next night as well. Went to the dog, "Well, go get some food now." "Great. Bit of meat over there, I said, I'll go over there." Out he went again. Came back again, 4 hours later, starving hungry, didn't find anything. Now this went on night after night after night. And he was getting hungrier and hungrier. And eventually he thought, "Well, I'm not going up tonight." And then the old bat came along and looked down and said, "Well, I'm going." And out went the old bat. About 20 minutes later, back in the old bat, covered in blood over all the teeth and the mouth and that, covered in it. And of course the young bat was so impressed. He looked up at him and said, "Oh, that's incredible. How do you do it? I've been up night after night, nothing. You've got 20 minutes, you've got everything you want. Where did you go?" And the old bat looked out and said, "Do you see that house over there?" "Yeah." "Do you see the gate there?" "Yeah." "Do you see the field beyond it?" "Yeah." "Can you just about see that tree over there?" "Yeah." He said, "Well, I didn't." I believe he likes animals as well. He's got quite a yearning for birds, apparently. But it's John Gordon singing "My Ain Folk."
my mate died, one friend, right? Some of you might have heard of him before. I remember, though, we were in primary school this one day, and the teacher gave us some homework to do. We had to go home and write about one of the books that we'd read recently. Only one sentence, just to describe what was in the book. So the next day, everybody came back to school, and the teacher was there, and she said, John, what have you written? John stood up and said, Lord of Flies by William Holden. An interesting book, all about little children who were stranded on a desert island and how to live there. She said, very John. Good John, did you enjoy it? Yes, miss, I did. Then she went to the next one, Simon. What have you read? Well, it was Lord of the Rings, miss, by Tolkien. Big book it was, miss. Took ages to read, but it was a book about little hobbits who were trying to destroy a magic ring. Very good, she said. Then she turned to Di. I said, Di, now, what have you been reading? And he got up and said, the name of the book, Mrs. Dictionary, by Collins. She said, he said, the story wasn't very interesting, but the words were well explained. We had a test, and I said he wasn't very bright, he hardly remembered anything. And we had a test, it was a geography test, knowing the capitals in Europe and the Middle East. And so, teacher with an affirmative, Di, you've been cheating. No, I haven't, miss. You haven't, Di, you've been cheating, I can tell. I'm looking at the papers. There's John's paper, there's yours. First question, what's the capital of England? John's got London. You've got London. Yes, miss. What's the capital of Wales? John's got Cardiff. You've got Cardiff. Yes, miss. Scotland? John's got Glasgow. You've got Glasgow. Yes, miss. It's wrong. What's the capital of Paris? Oh, sorry, capital of France, Paris, he said. You said Paris. All right, so far. And the next question, what's the capital of Turkey? He's written, I don't know, and you've written, neither do I. It's a minstrel medley, the next one coming up, starting and ending with Alexander's Ragtime Band.
Oh,
to happen eventually. Dad got married, of course. Well, he didn't exactly get married. He afterwards, of course. Oh, she would have been...
I'm
You went down to town, you dumped down for 4 hours, talking. Every night, pick up the phone, on the phone for 4 hours. Without a minute left, 4 hours, 5 hours some nights, night after night after night. This one night, she picked up the phone, 6 o'clock, on it for just an hour. And she walked into the kitchen afterwards and said, "Dude," I said, "What's the matter?" She said, "I got a wrong number."
Thank you. Thank you. Both sides, one. Mary in it.
I'm bowling.
Oh, great! Great! Now then, Ben.
You watch him send it flying.
You've got to get him moved.
You're not that flying.
Yes, he can shift up. Anyway, oh, look, one more end. Oh, I thought we finished.
Don't bounce it. Oh,
oh, good and Fred, you got that. Beaut. That'll take a bit of getting there.
Up to it. Go forehand so you can curl up to it. Don't go backhand.
You've got to move it then.
It'll curl around to it. But don't go, you know, you've got money to get up to there.
Aye, this is the best mat of the lot for doing that.
So you were.
It's too heavy.
Are you late to make any errors or
anything? Have the camera, I'll have a bit of a bowl.
Never mind.
Well, if we go for it, then just gently, so you draw for it.
Mr. Cameraman?
Yeah.
You're on.
Oh, am I on? Am I? Oh, all right.
Draw first. That's what you're trying to get a bit
better. You aren't half good to him, are you?
I do.
What did you say about him if you liked him?
I don't know. Better zoom up on him. See his pretty little face.
Hello, young candid camera.
Smile.
It comes right across.
Do your best, though, Alan.
It will. They will come across.
Well done. There
you are. Little piece of dish on there. We wore it out to that. It was a full job when we started.
It's up to you,
Kevin.
Put me on. Every end, they touch the
chest. Every end. I reckon it's a good match. You've just got to get your weight, that's the trouble. If you go on to the other match after you've had it.
Every end, they touch the chest.
Yes. Yeah. 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 Yeah.
Ruth and Harold are having an argument. Norman's coming in to tell him who's on.
He's got to go a little bit wider.
Come on, Ben, we've got.
You want to go fairly wide to get there? That's it, do it.
Which
was on that? Yes.
Just one.
Oh, eight. Oh, Bart's
going to love it.
We're one on.
We're
one.
Lucky to knock it out of the order.
Oh, super.
Beautiful.
What are you, blue? No, we're blue. You'll be red.
2 inches to go, Arrow.
Oh, yes.
We don't have any big runaway store.
Good one. Good one, Ray.
Slightly wider, aren't you, Harold?
Night, girls.
Good night, Harry.
What about the boys?
I'll not be bad. Hey, lad.
He's playing for the camera. The damn camera's going up and down. Yes, go on, Ruth.
Steady, stop on. Sit.
First time I've done it, I'm not good.
I did, I got you. I did get Harold's knocking the bottom. I got yours, Ruth.
We're trying to ring you snatch.
Did you get that last one of mine?
Yes.
Well, you've had a lot of rubbish on it.
Harold.
Not
going to get anywhere with that. Good on Brian, it's never a mile away.
When you move your one, it'll drop, Marilyn. Yeah, if you move that, it'll drop.
Nice way,
All on the last end, mate.
You stop, you got a left one.
Oh.
Yes. You're on for two.
Go on, what?
Barbara. Or Brenda. Barbara. Could you just go on to the right a little bit?
Yeah.
Thanks.
Yep. All right.
Yeah.
Missed it.
Gone too quiet for me.
Come inside your own house.
Not to worry. Oh,
here. Could you go a little bit higher up, please?
Pardon?
Could you go just a little bit? I just want to get the ball in the camera.
I forget when I'm doing that, you know, and I keep talking to somebody and I drop it down and I got more video of our carpet than anything.
I know, Harold does that.
Yes, nice. Don't you move, Brenda.
Just like that.
She's right there.
Chaplin, you went out of the way, didn't you?
Ooh. Oh, that's a good one.
That's out. Can you knock Glennis's off? Well, I'm Glenn. Yeah. Glennis says, it's not a toucher, so if you can knock, no, it's not a toucher. She can knock hers, you'll have two on. Even if you knock your own off, we're on.
Thank you.